Hello everyone, in this video I want to show you how to install an AMD CPU with its Wraith standard cooler. So I'm using in my video the Ryzen 7 5700G CPU that comes with the standard Wraith AMD CPU cooler. The motherboard I'm using is the Asus B550 Prime Plus that uses an AM4 socket, but the instructions I'm gonna show you apply also to other motherboards. So let's start. This is a CPU socket. And these here are for the CPU cooler. I'm gonna remove them after I install the CPU. So there is a lever here, push it down and then push it out and then bring it towards you like this. And this is the CPU. Always handle the CPU with care. So hope you can see it. Do not touch the pins of the CPU, just touch it from the sides. And notice here on the CPU, there's a small triangle. So I need to align this triangle with the triangle that is here. Just, you need to rest it on the socket without pushing it. Let gravity do its work. Make sure it is well installed. So now it is installed. Push down the lever. It becomes a little bit harder. And then push it in. Now the CPU is installed. And now I'm gonna install the Wraith cooler. The thermal paste comes pre-applied to this cooler. So this here is a thermal paste. It is pre-applied, do not touch it. And as I told you, I need to remove these brackets here in order to install it like this. So it should be installed like this, AMD facing like that. So put it on its back here. And let's remove these. I'm using here a magnetized Phillips head screwdriver. It's better to use a magnetized screwdriver so that it will hold the screws when you remove them. Do not discard these brackets. Maybe you'll need them in the future. So now let's install the CPU cooler. So this is it. Make sure when you rest it on the CPU, do not move it anymore so that the thermal paste will have maximum contact with the CPU. Just align the screws and always tighten the CPU cooler or any other thing diagonally. So don't tighten it too much. One thing I forgot to tell you is that when you remove these brackets, you have the back plate here that will fall in case you didn't put it flat on a surface like this. For me, it didn't fall, of course, because I put the motherboard flat. So this is good to know. So if you put it, like for instance, on its side, it will fall. Just be careful for this. As soon as the screw stops turning, just stop. And now let's connect the CPU cooler to the CPU fan header. Now the CPU and the Wraith cooler are installed. I hope that you liked this video and found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help the channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss any future videos I make. I'm Eloy, and I want to thank you all for watching. See you on the next video.